Hey guys,
what's up? How are you?
I hope everyone is doing good, and welcome back to another vlog of Ride with VJ.
So today I have got something very interesting for you. Most of my subscribers were asking me to do a comparison video between KTM RC125cc and Yamaha R15 V3. Well, both the motorcycles are wonderful machines in their respective categories. Both these are fed sports bikes, and let's compare them in terms of features, engine, technical specifications, so as to decide a winner. However, the KTM RC is a 125cc motorcycle against R15 V3. So the Yamaha R15 falls into the category of 150cc. So let's just get started.
Talk about the design of these motorcycles. So first, KTM. KTM RC 125 is positioned on a steel triple frame. Its design is inspired by the KTM RC 16 MotoGP racing bike. While it follows the distinct KTM color scheme of orange and white, it gets a triple clamp handlebar along with the twin projector headlamps with day running lights, low set clip-on handlebars, a digital instrument cluster, and 17 inches wheel fitted with 110 by 70 at the front and 150 by 60 tire section at the rear. At the other side, Yamaha R15 V3 is positioned on a Delta Classic. It sports a fully front fairing, LED headlamps, clip-on handlebars, and rear set foot pegs. Its fuel tank gets a design inspired by the larger R1, while it also receives a digital instrument cluster offering vital information coverage like speedo, odometer, tachometer, fuel gauge, clock, and gear position indicator. So the second thing comes with the dimensions of the motorcycle. Let's take KTM first. So KTM RC 125 measures 1977 mm in the length and has a wheelbase of 1341 mm, and the seat height is at 835 mm, while the ground clearance is at 157 mm, and it has a 9.5 liters of fuel tank, while the dry weight of the motorcycle is 154.2 kgs. And the other hand, Yamaha. So Yamaha R15 is longer than the KTM RC125. Stands 2060 mm, 2060 mm in the length, and it is 670 mm in the wide, and the 1070 mm in the height, while the wheelbase is also marginally longer at 1345 mm. It also gets the higher ground clearance at 160 mm. Thorough cabin weight is lower at 135 kgs, along with the seat height, which is at 790 mm. Now it's time to talk about the crucial and major part of this motorcycle's, nothing but engine. So KTM RC 125 uses the same engine as it's seen on the KTM 125 Duke. This 124.7cc is a single cylinder 4-valve DOHC liquid cool fuel injected engine. It offers 14.5 PS power at 9250 rpm and 12 Nm torque at 8000 rpm. Yes, of course, it is mated to a 6-speed telescopic forks in the front and monoshock with 10-step adjustable slots at the rear. Braking duties are carried out via 300 mm disc at the front and 230 mm disc at the rear, while single channel ABS from Bosch is offered as standard. At the other hand, Yamaha R15 gets its power via 150cc single cylinder liquid cooled engine, offering a higher power and torque as compared to that seen. The engine makes 16 bhp power at 8500 rpm and 15 Nm torque at 7500 rpm. Yes, of course, it is also mated with a 6-speed gearbox, and the bike gets telescopy fork at the front and a monoshock setup at the rear, while the brakes is handled by 267 mm disc brake in the front and 220 mm disc at the rear. It receives dual channel ABS as standard, as against the single channel ABS seen on its KTM RC125. Both the motorcycles are significant in their own categories. But if you look at the price range of KTM RC125, the ex-showroom price is 147,000 and R15 stands at little bit lower price rate at 1.42 lakhs, the ex-showroom price. Yes, it is 8,000 less than KTM RC125. Now the decision is all yours. Wearing a motorcycle like KTM RC125, you can do daily commutes with this in heavy traffic as well, because it's just 125cc and it gives the average of 40 kilometers per liter. And at the same time, you have R15 V3, which is also known for its power and stability. If you want that extra mile, extra power, so you can just go for the R15 V3. Even you can get that motorcycle at a little bit less price tag. Yes, it always depends upon your personal choice, your personal decisions, and it's always you to decide what you want. So I hope I am clear with this review. So that's it from my end. If you like this video, give me that big like and share this video with your friends and family. If you want to know anything about this motorcycle, please do comment below. I'll just revert back.
Stay tuned to Ride with VJ. A lot more to come. Signing off. See you in another video. Bye bye.